On behalf of the board of the Society for Creative Aging, welcome to ViVA Theater's production of Outrageous Fortune, directed by Jim Vallone. It is an insightful and humorous play by Colorado playwright and Shakespeare docent Rebecca Solomonsson. Rebecca, are you here?
Yes, I am.
Ha ha! Every year we put on two full productions at least in Boulder theaters. Fall show, like this one, and in the last half of May, we'll be doing our next spring show. We'll keep you posted. ViVA is by and for seniors, but we are truly an intergenerational group. Our production last year of Alice in Wonderland had a cast that ranged literally from 9 to 90. We have a lot of fun at ViVA, on and off stage. Please consider participating. You don't have to act. Just jot down your name, your email on the paper that's on the table just outside the doors. Hey, 2016 marks the 15th year that ViVA has taken plays, workshops, and art events to senior centers and retirement communities. We can only continue doing that with your support, our community, you. ViVA is part of the Society for Creative Aging, which is a registered nonprofit. We have overly discreet donation baskets there and out in the lobby. Hey, we really need your generosity. Thank you so much to our sponsors and those who advertise in our program. A last note, noisemakers, candy wrappers, restless husbands, and cell phones. This theater recently revamped, now has a high-tech security system. If your cell phone goes off during the play, it will be disintegrated by laser beams. So, it's in two acts tonight with a 15-minute intermission. So, without further ado, slings and arrows and a lot of laughs, here's Outrageous Fortune.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Prospera, and I am a Shakespearean character.
Hi, Prospera.
Let's open with our pledge of non-tragedian conformity.
Huh? I am a tragic character. Though I cannot change my past, I can change how I approach my future. I will not be defined by those who wrong me. From this day forward, I will be the captain of my own ship.
My own ship.
Please be seated. As you know, we have reached step 5 of our program. Today, we will identify those who wrong us, and determine how we wrong others.
Prosper, like, what if we don't like wrong anybody?
Proper introduction, please.
Oh, sorry. Hi, I'm Desdemona, and I'm a tragic character.
Hi, Desdemona.
Okay, so, like, my question is, what if we, like, never wrong anybody? I mean, seriously, I wouldn't hurt a fly. I'm, like, the most virtuous character in all of Shakespeare.
Well, we are all such complex beings. None of us is purely this or that. We are not purely good any more than our enemies are purely bad. That is what makes us such fascinating characters. And there is not one among us who has never wronged another in some way. Now, who would like to start?
Huh? Oh, I'll start. Hi, my name is Romeo, and I'm a tragic character.
Hi, Romeo.
Those that wrong me include my parents, Lord and Lady Montague, who continue to live in a feud with the Capulets, making it impossible for me to love my Juliet openly. At the top of the list of those I've wronged is Tybalt, whom I kill in a crime of passion after he kills Mercutio, my best friend. And I also wronged Juliet for killing Tybalt and causing me to be banished from Verona, thus making it impossible for us to be together.
There's no reason for me to be on that list, my love. I never blame you. Okay, maybe I blame you for a few minutes when I first learn of the incident, but then all is forgiven. Remember? Shall I speak ill of Romeo that is my partner?
I think you can cross Juliet off your list, Romeo.
I would like to go. I'm Cordelia, and I'm a tragic character.
Hi, Cordelia.
I'm with Desdemona. I'm a complete innocent in my story. But as for those who wrong me, I would have to say my evil sisters, Reagan and Goneril, who set the ball rolling on my tragic downward spiral. They screw everything up for everyone. And of course, my mother, Queen Lear, bears a certain amount of guilt as well.
But I learned my lesson, Cordelia, and I repent of my sins against you.
I know, but sometimes it still stings.
Your Majesty, would you like to be next?
Certainly. I'm Queen Lear, and I am a tragic character.
Hi, Queen Lear!
Those I wrong include my youngest daughter, Cordelia, who I have apologized to repeatedly. Those who wrong me are my daughters, Reagan and Goneril, who plot to take over my kingdom and then push me out into a raging storm and to my death. But I believe I wrong myself as well. I am too prideful, too vain, and too stubborn for my own good.
Mm-hmm. Next.
Hi, Desmond, a tragic character. Like I said, I'm completely innocent, but those who wrong me include Iago, who orchestrates my entire downfall. He convinces my husband, Othello, that I've been cheating on him, which I'm totally not. Then my husband, Othello, also wrongs me when he, like, murders me because he thinks I've been cheating on him, which I'm totally not. Also, my best friend and lady-in-waiting, Amelia, she wrongs me when she steals the handkerchief that my husband got for me. Now, she doesn't mean to wrong me at the time, but, like, she should totally know better than to steal that handkerchief. Oh, wait! I just thought of somebody that I wrong! I wrong my father because I run off and I marry Othello without his consent!
Next.
Hi, I'm Juliet, and I'm a tragic character.
Hi, Juliet!
My parents wronged me when they refused to delay my marriage to Paris and then abused me into submission. My father says he would rather I die in the street than not marry Paris. That just hurts so much every time. But I in turn wrong my parents when I take the potion given to me by the friar so that I can pretend that I'm dead.
Lady Anne?
I'm Lady Anne, and I'm a tragic character.
Hi, Lady Anne.
I wronged myself by going against my better judgment and marrying Richard, even though I know he has murdered my husband and my father-in-law. But he wrongs me when he murders me after he marries me.
I know. Ophelia.
Hi, I'm Ophelia, and I'm a tragic character.
Hi, Ophelia!
Hamlet definitely wrongs me. He treats me so badly with this whole get thee to a nunnery thing. He is like the world's worst boyfriend. He loves me, and then he doesn't. And then he does again. He also kills my mother, Polonia. Polonia and Claudius also wrong me when they use me like a puppet in their game of let's see if Hamlet is really mad or just faking it. And Gertrude watches me drown and doesn't save me. And I don't think I wrong anyone.
Thank you, Ophelia. Mistress Queen Macbeth, Lady Macbeth, would you like to have your say?
Nope.
No way.
Rosbeck, can I like say something, please?
Certainly, Desdemona, you have the floor.
Thank you. Okay, so like, we've been meeting here for like 5 weeks now, and for the life of me, I cannot imagine why the Macbeths are even here. I mean, seriously, you guys are not like victims of like tragedy. You guys like cause your own downfall. I mean, seriously, I don't even know why your play is called a tragedy. You like murder everyone in your way to get what you want.
Everyone. Perhaps they have feelings they would like to work through, just as we all do.
But they are kind of victims. We, at least, are victims of something. Fate, jealousy, our parents' feud. You are not. It makes me uncomfortable that you're even here.
You never even say anything. You just sit here brooding.
We don't have to justify ourselves to you.
We don't owe you anything. But if I were to justify myself, I would say that I'm a victim like the rest of you. I'm a victim of my partner.
And I would retort that I'm a victim of you, you manipulative snake.
How dare you? You're the one who decides you must kill the CEO so that you can take his position. I merely go along with the plan.
Oh, you push me into this murder when I'm ready to give up the idea.
Oh, please, you brainwash me into thinking I must be queen, and now you back out, coward.
Whoa.
I'm not comfortable with all this conflict.
I'm not sure you guys belong in a group situation. Maybe couples counseling?
We will have to address these issues another time. Now it is time to wrap up for today. Your assignment for next week, if you are comfortable doing so, is to confront those who wrong you. And then I would like you to think about a fatal flaw that you either possess or are somehow a victim of. And bring that fatal flaw with you to the next meeting.
I don't know if I'm ready to confront my daughters, and I don't think it will do any good. They're sly as rats, those two.
I leave that up to you. Shall we close with our pledge for a successful week?
I'm a tragic character, but I am not defined by my tragedy. I will go forth into my week with a positive attitude on how I can cope with my problems and move forward.
See you all next week.
on Hannah this week?
He used to listen to me, so maybe I can get him to see me for what I once liked in him. What about you? Are you going to have words with Iago?
Totes, my goats. I am so going to confront Iago.
All right. Good luck.
Thanks. Oh, you too. Have a great week.
So, Lear, what's your fatal flaw?
Vanity.
You? Weakness. And you, Cordelia?
I'm definitely a victim of my mother's vanity. She's so vain. She wants me to gush on and on about how much I love her. And when I don't, she casts me out of her home. Sometimes she can be such a jerk.
I'm standing right here. When are you going to stop punishing me?
I have my good days and I have my bad days. This is one of my bad days.
See you, Anne. Have a good week.
You too, Cordelia. Oh, Lear, take care.
You have to go back to our play and our family.
Yeah, I think I better get back, but I can probably sneak away tomorrow. Want to do the balcony scene with me?
Oh, I'd love to.
Until tomorrow then, my love.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Parting is such sweet sorrow that I will just say goodbye till it be morrow.
Tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow creeps in this petty pace from day to day till the last syllable of recorded time.
What are you saying?
Oh, I was just watching those young lovers saying goodbye and remembering when we were that young and in love. What changed between us?
Oh, I don't know. Committing murder together changes a relationship.
Oh, how I miss the way things used to be between us before our violent downfall.
Me too. Maybe we should consider marriage counseling.
Hey, that might not be such a bad idea.
Should I order stuffed pheasant for dinner?
Sounds delectable. Now does my project gather to a head. My charms crack not, my spirits obey, and time goes upright with his carriage.
Divided in three our kingdom, which of you shall we say doth love us most, that we our largest bounty may extend? Goneril, our eldest born, speak first.
Well, she's so vain. Look at them. She wants each one of her daughters to tell her how much they love her. And the one who says it best gets the largest share of her queendom. I love this part.
I love you more than word can wield the matter, as much as child e'er loved or mother found. A love that makes breath poor and speech unable beyond all manner of so much I love you.
What shall Cordelia speak? Love and be silent.
Tisk, 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 Cordelia. This is the beginning of your downfall. You actually do love your mama. Those two don't. Can't you come up with something?
What says our second daughter, our dearest Reagan? Speak.
I am the same metal as my sister. Only she comes too short that I profess myself to be an enemy to all other joys.
Then poor Cordelia.
Now, our joy, although our last and least, what can you say to draw a third more opulent than your sisters? Speak.
Nothing, my lady.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Nothing will come of nothing. Speak again.
Come on, Cordelia, say something. Anything. Thy bounty is as boundless as the sea. How do I love thee? Let me count the ways. Shakespeare does have some great material.
I'm happy that I am. I cannot heave my heart into my mouth. I love your majesty according to my bond. No more, no less.
So young and so untender.
So young, my lady, and true.
Let it be so. Hence and avoid my sight. Better thou hadst not been born than not have loved me better.
Let's get them in their scene alone. We can catch them in their deceit. Can you believe her? That little sister of ours is such a little fool. I mean, you'd think that she'd at least lie about how much she loves her, like we do. Oh, she could never be an actress.
Oh, but you could win a Tony for your performance.
I love you as much as Goneril does, but much more. Oh, ick, I can't stand the vain, self-centered old bat.
But the good news is, she's cut Cordelia out of the bargain so that you and I can have an equal share. The only problem is, the time sharing that we have to do.
I can't stand the thought of having to live with her part of the time, can you?
Oh, I'm gagging at the very idea.
Oh, we need to do something about it. Oh, I think I have an idea.
Oh, do tell. You guys can listen to me. You lying, wicked wenches!
Oh, good. Look who's back. The tyrant and the marshmallow.
You think we're afraid of you? You old goat.
Oh, and you little bird. I could crush you beneath my heel.
What is this? Some sort of intervention? I mean, you eavesdrop on our conversation in order to prove to yourselves that we're wicked?
Oh, you already knew that, so what? What are you going to do about it now?
We know we cannot change the outcome of our play. What's written cannot be unwritten. This is a confrontation.
We want an apology.
An apology? You want an apology? Isn't that precious?
Oh, sweetie. We can't apologize to you. You deserve what you get. You make your own bad choices in the play. We don't do that for you.
Maybe not, but you take advantage of our weaknesses. You drive me to my death. And just when Cordelia and I are to reunite and all can be redeemed, the man you plot and scheme with has her killed, which in turn kills me. I say you owe us an apology.
You bring it on yourselves.
Look, we all arrive at the same fate. Death is our end, no matter who or what we are in life. We just want a little closure. Don't you want to die with a clear conscience, knowing you've at least owned up to all the horrible things you've done?
No. I'm good.
And now, if you'll kindly stop wasting our time, we have some murders to plot.
How sharper than a serpent's tooth it is to have a thankless child. Oh, Cordelia, what I would give to know at the end of the play what I know at the beginning.
I know, Mother.
Come, will you dine with me?
Of course.
So I am forgiven.
You are forgiven.
Not so fast.
Not you again. I thought I told you. You are not a part of my life anymore.
It's not that simple.
Who is this, Mother?
I should not need an introduction, Cordelia. You know me well. I am Vanity.
your mama's fatal flaw. Aren't I beautiful?
I should have guessed.
And you can't get rid of me so easily, Lear. I'm a part of you, and I always will be, no matter how you repent of your sins.
That is not true. One may escape one's flaws, provided one wishes to change them. You may be a part of me at the beginning of the play, but I overcome you in the end. My goodness wins. Come, daughter, let's away.
You might try to get rid of me, but you'll be back. Oh. They always come back, one way or another, for a person may not escape their true nature.
To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles, and by opposing, end them. Soft you now, the fair Ophelia.
Hold it right there, cowboy. Where do you think you're going?
What? Who the devil are you and what do you mean by interrupting this pivotal scene in the play?
I'm your fatal flaw, and I suggest you pause for a moment and consider what it is you are about to do.
What exactly is my fatal flaw?
Well, scholars seem to think that it may be indecisiveness, your inability to act. But I'm not sure that's your problem.
And what do you think is my problem?
Well, what isn't your problem?
You've got some nerve. What say you get out of my way and let me deal with Ophelia?
That's one problem right there. You and Ophelia. She's such a sweet girl. And you know you love her. But I, your fatal flaw, drive you to curse her and abuse her.
She betrays me!
Well, it's her mother and Claudius that put her up to it. And even if she knows about it, whether or not she does is up to the director.
Still, it hurts me.
Oh, me, me, me. It's all about you, isn't it? Maybe I am ego. Maybe that's your fatal flaw. You only care about yourself.
And avenging my father's death. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Or existentialism. Maybe that's what that whole to be or not to be is about, right? What's the point of existence? You overthink everything. Now wait. I'm having an identity crisis here. And I need you to help me figure out what it is that drives you to your demise. The other fatal flaws are picking on me.
Good luck with that.
Oh. 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 Good, my lord. How does your honor for this many a day?
I humbly thank you. Well, are you honest?
My lord.
Are you fair?
What means your lordship?
That if you be honest and fair, your honesty should admit no discourse to your beauty.
Wait a minute. We need to stop.
Stop? You can't stop in the middle of our scene. What is it with all of these interruptions today?
We need to talk. I can't do this anymore.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about the way you treat me in this scene. You rant and rave at me. You physically and verbally abuse me. It's wrong. I'm in therapy because of you.
It's not my fault. It's her fault.
Who's that?
My fatal flaw.
Hey, Ophie, what's happening?
Don't use your fatal flaw as a scapegoat. You're responsible for your own actions.
No, he's actually not. I have him totally under my power.
Quiet! This is a private conversation.
Well, your mother and Claudius are overhearing every word.
Right. I almost forgot about that. You can come out now, Mother.
Your Majesty.
Oh, hey, it's Gertrude. Now there's a party. I need your help. I want you to tell me what you think I am. I think I've narrowed it down to ego and existentialism and indecisiveness. What do you think?
It could be any one of those.
That's not helpful.
Can we get back to me now, please? Mother, Claudius, have you anything to say to me?
Well, you may as well know it right now, daughter. Claudius and I, we set this whole thing up in order to determine whether Hamlet was mad or not. Yes, I already know. You use me. You use me like a mouse to catch a cat.
Meow.
Claudius, is this true? How could you?
Well, Hamlet's physical and emotional responses to you are perfect indications of his madness.
I am but mad north-northwest. When the wind is southerly, I know a hawk from a handsaw.
We do it for the good of all parties involved, daughter.
But do you realize that in trying so hard to prove that Hamlet is mad, you drive me mad in the process?
Yes, I know. Some repercussions are to be expected.
I die for your information!
Oh.
I drown! No thanks to Gertrude here.
Mm. What? You can't blame me for your death. You go mad. You fall in the water. A servant comes and tells me you're dead, and I tell your brother. That is all I know of your death.
Really? You tell my brother, and I quote, "Her clothes spread wide and mermaid-like, a while they bore her up, which time she chanted snatches of old loves." How would you know any of that unless you were there, watching me sink to my watery grave?
A good guess?
Aren't you all aware that we are on a downward spiral to destruction? Not one of us gets out of here alive. Don't you think that's obscene?
Yeah. It's a bit of a bummer.
You're so caught up in your deceitfulness and your destruction that you don't care who you take with you. I'm the only innocent one here.
I'm innocent. I'm completely innocent. I have no idea what my husband did or does, and I don't want to know.
Look, Hamlet, I've done a lot of internal work to accept my fate. All I'm asking for is some explanation. What happened between us?
I did love you once.
Indeed, my lord. You made me believe so.
You should not have believed me. I loved you not.
I don't want to do the scene right now, Hamlet. I'm trying to talk to you on an honest level here.
We all know your mother and my husband are to blame for everything that happens.
No, I'm not to blame. You're to blame, Polonia. Yes, it was your daughter after all. You shouldn't treat her in this terrible manner.
You're my king. I have to go along with all your plots and schemes.
I've always respected you for your good counsel. I might listen if you went against my wishes here.
On not getting caught for the murder of the previous king, that you will do anything to keep Hamlet out of the way.
Oh, I didn't know you knew about that.
What murder? What king?
Oh.
I don't want to know. La, 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 la.
Mother, Claudius, Gertrude, please. This is about me. Focus on me for a minute. Hamlet, what do you have to say to me?
Fine. Ophelia, this whole scene we do is poppycock. I'm madly in love with you the whole time, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
This scene kills me. I'm only cruel to you because I know that the king and your mother are watching and I want them to think that I'm mad.
Okay, I understand.
I hate that my last words to you are, to a nunnery go. I hate that I can never tell you how I truly feel about you.
You love me. That's all I wanted to know.
Ophelia, you complete me.
We can go back to the scene now.
Oh, daughter, please, please forgive me. Had I known how this all would have turned out, I would have taken you far away from this place.
Good. As long as you know you're wrong, I forgive you. Claudius, have you anything to say?
No, I have no regrets.
Really?
Wow.
Okay, Gertrude, you?
What do you want me to apologize for? Honestly, I'm as much a victim as anyone else.
Okay. Well, two apologies out of four isn't bad. I'm ready to move on. Now, where were we?
Let's take it from get thee to a nunnery. Ready?
Ready.
Get thee to a nunnery. Why wouldst thou be a breeder of sinners? I am myself indifferent, honest. But yet I could accuse me of such things, that it were better my mother had not borne me.
We are going to try to work through some issues together and see if we can't reach a point of understanding. Have you both identified me as your fatal flaw?
Yes, ambition. You are deeply seated in each of us.
Not me. You're the one with the ambition problem. Denial. So you're going to go that route. Then, what I'd like to do is start the scene where Mistress Queen Macbeth is contemplating abandoning the plan to kill the CEO.
All right. We will proceed no further in this business.
Was the hope drunk wherein you dressed yourself? Hath it slept since, and wakes it now to look so green and pale at what it did so freely? From this time such I account thy love.
There you see, ambition. She's calling my love into question, saying I don't love her, that I'm unfaithful to her as I'm unfaithful to the plan to kill.
Ambition is not my driving force. I am angry because you're going back on the plan. I'm a very structured individual. When I plan to have pheasant for dinner, I want to have pheasant for dinner. when we expect to go to a show, I want to go to a show. And when we plan to kill someone, I expect to kill someone. It's that simple.
All right, I can see that.
But we're not at the meat of the scene yet. Keep going.
Pretty peace. I dare do all that may become a woman. Who dares do more is none.
What beast was it that made you break this enterprise to me? When you durst do it, you were powerful. And to be more than what you were so much more a woman.
And now you attack my womanhood? In order to be powerful, I have to commit murder? If that's your criteria for a leader, why did you marry me in the first place? I had not killed anyone then.
That's not the point. You're weak when you go back on your word. I'm disappointed. I expected all these riches and to be queen, and now here you are telling me that's not going to happen.
Right. That is me in a nutshell. That's all my traits. Right there.
Oh, butt out. I am not ambitious. I just want my partner to succeed, that's all.
Listen, there is nothing wrong with being ambitious. I am a very good trait to have. The problem with you two is that you misdirect me and use me for evil instead of good.
If you're so free of ambition, why do you put so much thought into this murder? Think of your little speech to me that begins, screw your courage to the sticking place and will not fail. And then you proceed to describe how you'll give lots of wine to all the servants and they'll pass out and won't remember anything. And then we can kill and blame them for the murder.
You know me, I'm a planner. I'm very detail-oriented.
Oh, I don't know how far we're going to get with this today. Clearly you two are more interested in fighting with each other than working out your issues. I don't even know what I'm here for, honestly.
Look, all I want is for you to accept your culpability. I want you to see that we're in this together. Stop blaming me for everything.
Now we're getting somewhere. Lady Macbeth, what do you think of your partner's feelings?
Fair enough. I believe I am culpable. I don't blame you for everything.
Well done. This is a huge step forward.
And I want you to understand that even though I might be a bit ambitious, my ambition is mostly for you. I want your power before I want my own. Everything I do in support of you.
A very articulate expression of valid feelings.
You have been very thoughtful.
There now, don't we all feel better taking responsibility for our own actions instead of assigning blame?
Oh, there's still plenty of blame to assign. It's all your fault.
My fault?
She is right. If it wasn't for you, we wouldn't behave the way we do.
No. It does not work that way. Human beings are given the gift of reason. You are not slaves to your personality traits. You are capable of overcoming them.
You can't weasel your way out of all this.
So what are you going to do to me?
Something we should have done a long time ago.
Oh, help! I'm being repressed!
This is my favorite part of the play. This is where I really shine. Everyone else in this play has been pretty strong, but that Lady Anne, man, She is so weak-willed, she couldn't snap a twig in half.
Well, I can see why you like this scene, Weakness. She is definitely at her weakest.
I couldn't do it without you. She really falls for Richard.
Oh, yes. Yes. There's Richard.
A vile, dreadful minister!
See? She starts out pretty strong, but somehow he gets the better of her, and it's all downhill from here.
I know. You can watch it unfold like a paper fan, crease by crease.
Sweet saint, for charity, be not so cursed.
Foul devil, for God's sakes, hence, and trouble us not!
Oh, Richard comes on pretty strong here. Not bad for a guy who killed her husband and her father-in-law. You have got to give it to the bad boys of Shakespeare.
Lady, you know no rules of charity which renders good for bad, blessings for curses.
Villain, thou knowest no law of God nor man. No beast so fierce but know some touch of pity.
Oh, this is where I start doing my magic for Richard. He doesn't love her, but he is about to convince her that he does.
Yes, it's beautiful.
Watch how he does it.
Didst thou not kill this king?
I grant you.
Wait for it.
Thy beauty was the cause of that effect. Thy beauty that did haunt me in my sleep to undertake the death of all the world, that I might live 1 hour in your sweet bosom.
Oh, and there it is! Brilliant!
If I thought that were true, these nails should rend that beauty from my cheeks!
See? She's a real pistol here in this part.
Oh, it is a quarrel most unnatural to be revenged on him that loveth thee.
Oh, you have to watch this part. This is a brilliant speech. He tells her that he really loves her, that he killed her husband out of love for her so he could marry her. I mean, it is so romantic. Any girl would fall for it.
Any girl with me is her fatal flaw. Yeah, sure.
Lo, here, I lend thee this sharp-pointed sword. Nay, do not pause, for I did kill King Henry. But 'twas thy beauty that provoked me. Nay, now dispatch. 'Twas I that stabbed young Edward. But 'twas thy heavenly face that set me on.
Arise, dissembler, for though I wish thy death, I will not be thy executioner.
And my work here is done.
We make a great team, destroying an innocent individual.
I would I knew thy heart.
It is figured in my tongue.
I fear me both are false.
Never was man true.
She should stick to her instincts here. Thank God she doesn't, or I'd be out of a job.
Lovely wordplay here. This really is excellent writing. Mm.
Vouchsafe to wear this ring.
Oh, kissy poo!
To take is not to give.
But it kind of is.
Look how this ring encompasseth thy finger. Even so thy breast encloseth my poor heart. Wear them both, for both of them are thine.
Much it joys me to see you become so penitent.
Bid me farewell.
'Tis more than you deserve. But since you teach me how to flatter you, imagine I have said farewell already.
Well, since you teach me how to flatter you, she despises him in the beginning, and in a span of minutes, he convinces her to marry him. Well played, deception.
Well played. Thank you, Weakness, but I couldn't have done it without you.
Was ever woman in this humor wooed? Was ever woman in this humor won? I'll have her, but I'll not keep her long.
That is really great stuff, Richard. Really great stuff. We did it again.
She showed particular weakness this time, if I do say so myself.
Well, I couldn't have done it without the two of you. And now, I must be off, for I have more people to kill, including Anne.
Deception, you'll be along for the ride, I expect.
I wouldn't miss it.
Hey, catch you guys later.
Hey, bye week this. We need to do it again real soon.
Oh, you're still here? I tried to confront him this time. I really did. I just could not work up the nerve. I mean, he wears me down and he takes all the fight right out of me.
You are too much a part of me.
And I hate you for that. I am murdered because of you.
So what are you going to do?
I don't know. I mean, maybe I can't confront him face to face, but there might be another way I can get my revenge.
Revenge? You don't have it in you.
I might. If, you know, under the right circumstances, and if enough of the other characters were behind me.
What do you have in mind?
Well, you know, I was thinking, if he, I mean, he thinks he wants to marry me, so I think maybe if I do it.
But soft, what light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and Juliet is the sun. It is my lady. Oh, it is my love. See how she leans her cheek upon her hand. Oh, that I were a glove on that hand, that I might touch that cheek.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name, or if thou wilt not, be but sworn my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet.
I'll take thee at thy word. Call me love, and I be new baptized. Henceforth, I never will be Romeo.
I miss this.
Oh, me too.
Sometimes I wish things could have worked out for us. Do you ever think about what could have been?
Sure, but then we would be a comedy and not nearly as profound. This way, we have so much to teach those who learn of our story.
It's not fair.
I know.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Hi, Faith. Thank you for coming.
I think maybe I can help you today.
Oh, mm-hmm. We're going to need all the help we can get. Mm-hmm.
Here they come.
What noise is this? Give me my long sword.
Crutch, a crutch. Why call you for a sword?
My sword, I say. Old Montague is come and flourishes his blade in spite of me.
Thou villain Capulet, hold me not. Let me go.
Thou shalt, monster, one step
to take a bow. Up your swords, you know not what you do. Rebellious subjects, enemies to peace. Throw your mistempered weapons to the ground.
Wait, this is not where we usually do this scene. You're not the Prince of Verona. Why are we in the Capulet's backyard?
What is this, Capulet? Some kind of ploy to get us on your turf so that you can badger us?
This is not my doing, Montague. Aww. I wouldn't invite you over if you were the last snail on earth and I needed someone to eat my rubbish.
If you would calm down for a moment and ask your children what is going on, I think they will have an explanation for you.
Romeo, why are we all here? You know your father and Capulet have restraining orders against each other.
Mother, come on over here and sit down. You too, Pops. Come sit by Mother. Lord and Lady Capulet, will you please sit down? All right. I know you're wondering why we ask you here. Juliet and I...
You have bewitched my daughter! That's the only possible explanation for why she is socializing with a Montague.
She's socializing with a Montague because her own people are not worthy. She's bettering herself with our son's company.
Bettering herself? I'm sorry. Juliet,
Step away from that boy before he infects you with his worthlessness. He is positively dripping with it.
Mother, can you please listen to what we have to say?
Dripping with worthlessness? My son does not run away from, fake his own death, so he can run away from home like your daughter does.
Well, at least my daughter isn't a cold-hearted killer like your son is.
Stop. Thank you. No one speak. I would like to introduce myself. I'm Fate, and I'm here to help mediate this conversation today. Juliet?
Thank you, Fate. Romy and I think it's time we all talk about what really happens in our play.
Oh, Juliet, I really don't want to listen to this right now.
What a surprise. You're not listening to your daughter. Shocker.
Zip it, you canker blossom.
Oh, enough.
Flex wench.
Mother, when I tell you I won't marry Paris, you refuse to listen to me and then turn against me. Father, you berate and abuse me. Neither one of you will listen to what I have to say.
You are my daughter. I provide a roof over your head and clothing for your winter and food for your eat. The least you can do is be entirely obedient to me in all things.
You see, this is where I have a problem with your parenting style. Children should be allowed a small bit of freedom.
Freedom to wander the streets and get involved in gang violence, you mean? I don't think you're exactly a pillar of parental morality.
I think we can all agree that both sides are lacking in the child-rearing department.
I'm sorry, who are you again?
And who exactly do you think you are telling us we are lacking as parents?
Do you have children?
No.
Are you a child psychiatrist?
No.
Parenting expert?
No, I bring perspective to a difficult situation.
I don't have time for this. Juliet, come. We're going home.
No, Mother. We're all staying right here.
What a shocker. Juliet is defying you. Again.
You all must come together in the interest of peace and tranquility. Will everyone please be a little more open-minded? That's the spirit. I'm here because I play a vital role in your play. Romeo and Juliet are fated to meet and fated to die, according to Shakespeare. But you all make choices that hurry their tragic fate along, do you not? Let's start by identifying the choices you all make and how they affect the outcome. Who would like to begin?
Well, I, for one, would like to take this opportunity to speak. I speak so little in the play. And then I die of a broken heart when Romeo is banished. But I love my son. I wish that he had come to me with his love for Juliet. I might have been able to talk some sense into my husband. Perhaps the gap between the two families might have been bridged. If I have one regret about my actions, it is that I was not closer to my son. I never asked him to confide in me. I never taught him the smart choices that might have saved.
I have regrets too. I failed Juliet as mother. I know that. We never bonded properly when she was a child. That's why she went to her nurse with everything. I know, Juliet. But why are you putting us through this again? You know that I suffer so much with your death. Why must you make me relive it when we're not even in production?
I'm not trying to punish you, Mother. I just want you to understand why I do what I do in our play. You and Father refuse to hear me when I tell you I won't marry Paris. So of course I can't tell you about my love for Romeo. Father almost kills me as it is. Think what he would do to me if I were to come clean and tell you everything, that I'd married in secret to the son of your enemy.
No, no, I think the real culprit is you, Fate. Yeah, we're just all victims of the society that our writer has written for us. It's not our fault.
It's time to accept responsibility for your own actions.
Oh, no, 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 I think she's right. It says in the prologue, star-crossed lovers, death-marked love. We can't stop feuding until they die. They have to die in order for us to stop feuding, see? So, Faith, your fault.
Oh, you flatter me. I would love to think that I had that much control over you, that humans are fated to this or that, and that there is nothing you can do to change it. But I don't think it's that simple.
Well, humans may be capable of changing their fate by making the right decisions. But we are not exactly human. We are characters in a play, and therefore subject to our fate, trapped by the words that compose our makeup.
Fate is not to blame. Juliet and I just want some acknowledgement of the choices that were made that led us to our fatal end. We married in secret because, number one, we're young and foolish and rash. And number two, because of the feud that you continue to perpetuate. I resent being blamed for this.
Your exact words to me when I refuse to marry Paris are, hang that thaw, die in the sweets, for by my soul, never nothing.
I'm your father. I'm the man of the house. I'm not accustomed to be disobedience.
I can't believe you would say such a thing to your own daughter.
Really? You ought to be ashamed.
Well, you want to discuss parenting techniques again? You absentee father.
Uh-huh, yeah? Huh, you sound like a broken record, you know that?
Yes, do you have anything to say, Capulet, that isn't a criticism of our parenting skills?
No, I don't. Your son corrupts my daughter.
Your daughter corrupts our son.
That's it! Yes. Oh!
Whoa!
Taking you down.
Huh?
Oh! Here we go. You're a terrible.
You're terrible.
Oh! Hey! Oh! 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 Absolutely!
what will you give me now for that same handkerchief which so often you did bid me steal?
Hast thou stolen it from her?
No. Faith, she let it drop by negligence.
A good wench, give it me.
What will you do with it that you've been so earnest to have me filch it?
I have use for it. Now get thee gone, go. I in Cassio's lodging will lose this napkin, and he will find it. Trifles light as air are to the jealous, confirmations strong as proof of holy writ. This may do something. The more already changes with my poisons.
What are you doing here? Get out of here! You're gonna ruin everything!
Oh, I'll ruin everything! Me! That little handkerchief is the only thing standing between me and, like, death. And you say I'll, like, ruin everything?
Mm-hmm.
Give it to me.
No.
It's mine!
No!
Give it!
No!
Finders, keepers!
What are you gonna do, Desdemona? You can't change the play.
Oh,
it's already been written.
Yeah, you don't think I, like, know that? Day after day, century after century, you plot, you scheme, you, like, plant the seeds of jealousy in Othello's mind.
And I do a masterful job. Artistic in its simplicity, with all the delicacy of a spider spinning its web. Brilliant.
And you, you're like my best friend. Why do you do it, Amelia? Why do you steal this handkerchief?
You know how sorry I am once I fully realize what I've done.
Okay, you know what? You're right. You're not really the one that I'm mad at. You are! Throughout the play, you, like, get under Othello's skin. You, like, worm your way into his heart. You, like, convince him that I'm cheating on him, which I'm totally not. Mm. And the jealousy, like, eats him away from the inside like a parasite.
Yeah.
Does it, like, never occur to you he's gonna, like, kill me?
Well, of course it does. I hope the whole play that he's gonna kill you. My only goal in this play is revenge. Watching him fall apart, bit by bit, moment by moment, until he falls apart like a clay pot in my fist. Oh. It's very satisfying, really. Oh, well, I suppose from this little interruption in our usual daily routine that you're looking for some sort of an apology.
Yeah. An apology would be, like, lovely. Like, I'm in, like, therapy right now, and I'm trying to find some kind of, like, closure.
Yeah. You're not gonna get one. I'm not sorry. I never have been, and I never will be. My evil genius has inspired generations of villains. The evil that men do lives after them. The good is often turned with their bones. I wish to live forever.
Wow. I'm, like, just a little taken aback by, like, how, like, totally evil you are.
Well, I guess you're gonna have to get used to it, sweetheart.
And what about me? Do you care anything for me, Iago? I'm your wife, after all. And you murder me for exposing you for what you are. Do you have any regrets about that?
Just unfortunate collateral damage, my dear.
I want a divorce!
Well, ladies, I'd love to stay and chit-chat about the morals of revenge and murder and my unrepentant ways, but I have a man to ensnare in the web of jealousy, so I am going to need that hanky back.
Why did you do that?
Look, Iago's right. I can't, like, change the outcome of the play.
Oh.
know why you expected an apology out of him. He is bad to the core.
I am a tragic character. Though I cannot change my past, I can change how I approach my future. I will not be defined by those who wrong me. From this day forward, I will be the captain of my own ship.
Right. I am feeling it. A great deal of tension here today. Who would like to open the meeting with how things went for you this week?
Hi, I'm Desdemona, and I'm a tragic character.
Hi.
Save it! Look, I would love to talk about how my week went. This is my guest. This is not a fatal flaw. Her name is Amelia. She's my trusted friend and lady-in-waiting. Her spouse, Iago, is the one who orchestrates my entire downfall, and we had an awesome conversation with Iago, didn't we, Amelia?
Oh, it was grand.
Yeah.
I filed for divorce because of it. Mm-hmm.
I confronted Iago. Iago laughed in my face and told me that there was no regrets and no remorse.
I'm very sorry to hear that, Desdemona.
Yeah, me too.
We do not always get the results we want from these encounters, but we do them for ourselves to find our own closure, not to change the one we are confronting.
I tried to confront Richard, I really did, but he is so manipulative, and I fall for it every time. And weakness here does nothing to help.
Sorry, darling. I'm your fatal flaw. It's what I do.
Romeo and I didn't have much luck either. Our parents can't stop fighting with each other. We could barely get a word in edgewise.
Our parents can be such children sometimes.
Mm-hmm. My confrontation went pretty well. Hamlet still loves me.
My sisters are still evil.
Evil as cats that have been infected by an evil virus that makes them bleed evil from their eyeballs.
So the confrontations did not go as well as we would have hoped. Oftentimes, the other characters will evolve into a fuller understanding over time. So we try again.
No,
never again.
It's been 400 years since we were written. How much more time do they need to evolve?
Good point. What say we move on to identifying our fatal flaws? Macbeth, would you like to explain why your fatal flaw is bound and gagged?
This is ambition. She is responsible for our rise and fall, so we are repressing her.
Repressing her?
Sure, we're tired of our murderous, ambitious ways. We decided together that we're going to be good from now on. No more ambition, no more murder.
You're changing your story?
You can't do that!
I want to do that! How can I do that?
No, you can't! That's like the worst crime any character could commit!
I must protest, Lady Macbeth. Desdemona is right. You can't change your story.
Really? And who's going to stop us? My partner and I are ready to live a crime-free life. We've suppressed our ambition, so we can't be a part of this.
You have got to think about the consequences of changing your story.
I think they're right to do what they want. I mean, why should we just sit back and let someone else decide for us how we should live our lives and what should become of us?
Because we're characters. We're written characters thought up in someone's imagination. He gave us life, and as a writer, it's his right to take our lives away.
Oh, he's a hack.
And would you like to introduce your fatal flaw?
This is weakness. It's because of my weakness that I fall for Richard, even though I know it's a horrible idea. He takes advantage of me in a weakened state. I am weak-willed, weak from exhaustion, weak from grief.
I'm very glad to be here.
Sit down.
Ophelia, who have you put on?
Well, this is Hamlet's fatal flaw, HFF for short. We can't really define her, but whatever she is, she makes Hamlet self-destruct.
I'm drowning in my identity crisis. Prospera, please tell me what I am. Then perhaps I can help you figure that out. Your Majesty and Cordelia, who did you bring along?
Vanity.
Present. Everyone admire me. Yes, and Romeo and Juliet.
Fate. She isn't exactly a fatal flaw, but she does kind of determine the course of our lives and deaths, arguably.
Well, this is excellent. And many thanks to you fatal flaws for being here today. Now, we are going to do a visualization and meditation exercise. Close your eyes and imagine you and your fatal flaw alone on an island together. There is only you and the personality trait that brings about your downfall. Ah, now imagine yourselves running hand in hand along the shore, splashing in the waves, having fun as friends do. Imagine you are perfectly at peace with your fatal flaw. And now imagine yourself giving your fatal flaw a hug. And as you embrace, you are bathed in a golden light. Great. Now open your eyes and give your fatal flaw a real hug.
Oh, this is stupid.
It's natural to feel some trepidation with this exercise.
No, this is really stupid. I mean, we come here week after week and we complain about our lives and our fatal flaws and our fates and our deaths, but we're not really doing anything to change anything. We're just sitting here talking. I'm tired of talking. I want to do something. I'm sorry, Prospera. I know that you mean well, but I just don't think this group is working out.
No, I'm with Anne. I wish I'd never, like, joined in the first place.
Do others feel this way? I see. Well, I'm glad to have helped those of you who have found it useful, and if you wish to continue, I would be happy to meet with you. I feel I have failed the rest of you, and for that, I am truly sorry. I shall take my leave of you.
Hurt Prospera's feelings. No one forced you to join this group, and she's been here for us out of the goodness of her heart. What is it you want, Anne?
I want revenge on Richard!
See, that sounds awesome. I want revenge on Iago.
Okay, let me stop you right there. What you're talking about is completely illegal. Not to mention impossible. Just what exactly are you planning to do?
I'm still working out the details.
Well, normally I'm all for revenge and murder and whatnot, but Queen Mistress Macbeth and I have turned over a new leaf. We've repressed our ambition, so we can't take part of this.
To be honest, dear, I'm already starting to miss ambition. I don't know if I can continue to repress her.
Well, then untie her and join us.
Oh, I'm really shocked to hear you talking like this. Desdemona, you of all characters, why would you sacrifice your goodness? You're all that's virtuous and pure in Shakespeare. Some of us look up to you for that.
Look, Juliet, I'm sorry to like disappoint you, but I'm like sick of being like virtuous and pure. Okay. Look, if we can find a way to exact revenge against those who wrong us, why shouldn't we do it? Who's in?
I'm in.
Yes.
Cordelia, no, I forbid it.
But I want revenge on Regan and Goneril.
They already die in the end. What more do you want?
I can't forgive them for what they do to you.
My sweet daughter, I know how you care for me, but punishing your sisters won't prove that any more than your loyalty to me.
I know, but I still want in.
And I can't resist a good murderous mutiny.
Are you with me, dear?
Oh, what the heck? Sure.
Yes.
Wow, that was a quick turnaround.
What can I say? My lust for blood and murder overcomes my desire to be good every time.
So, we have Cordelia, the Macbeth, Desdemona, Anne, and me. That's six of us. Anyone else? Last chance for sweet, sweet revenge. Romeo and Juliet?
No, our parents suffer enough.
We don't want vengeance, and you shouldn't either. You should learn to accept your fate the way we've learned to accept ours.
Lear?
No, and I will do everything in my power to keep Cordelia from going through it as well.
Ophelia?
I'm in.
What? Why? You said your confrontation went well.
Who do you want revenge on?
Well, I've forgiven Hamlet and my mother, but Claudius and Gertrude won't take any responsibility for what happens to me.
Great, Ophelia makes seven of us.
Woo! Woo! All right, everybody come with me, and I'll tell you what I have in mind. I don't think it's going to be that difficult, because really, I don't think they're that bright.
We can't sit back and let them get away with this.
We have to stop them.
How? We don't even know what they're planning to do.
I can help with that.
Prosper, hi, you're back. We thought that you'd left.
I hid so I could listen in. Let's follow the others and see what they are up to.
What a hoot! All of it. I thought Lear was the only vain one, but I'm part of all of them. They are all vain enough to think that they can change their fate.
Which we all know none of them can.
Oh, they can if they're ambitious enough.
Oh, but they're not human. They're characters. They're fated to the whims of their writer, who has chosen their fate for them.
But that doesn't mean they shouldn't try, does it?
Of course they shouldn't try. They're only going to cause trouble.
And I'm going to enjoy every minute of it.
Oh, I think I'll stay here. Oh, I don't know. Oh, who am I kidding? I'm in.
Yeah. Where are Romeo and Juliet? They can't escape from me. I'll lay in wait for them.
These characters think they can live without us, but they can't. We define them.
I'm so lost without Anne. She's entirely deserted me. There's not an ounce of weakness in her anymore.
Oh, don't worry. The weakness will come back. Let's go have coffee together soon. I could sure use a hand understanding what my definition is.
Yeah, sure.
I guess.
Oh, it's horrible! It's horrible! What they are planning! If we do not stop them, they will destroy us all!
everyone, shall we open with our Scoundrels Anonymous pledge?
I am a Shakespearean scoundrel. I do not wish to change my behavior. I wish to accept myself for who I am and revel in all the destruction I cause.
All the destruction I cause.
Thank you. Well, I would like to introduce some new members we have with us today, Lady Montague and Lord and Lady Capulet. Would you like to say a few words about what brings you here today?
You don't belong here. I can tell you by just looking at you.
Lady Montague made us come.
On account of our bad behavior towards each other.
Well, we are under the impression that the Scoundrels Anonymous meeting would be a place for those wishing to overcome their inner scoundrels. Seems I was mistaken.
Oh no, we have no desire to change.
Oh, we're proud of who we are.
I'm a duplicitous genius.
I really like my sly use of poison.
I like my way with words.
Oh, I think I'm especially gorgeous and sneaky.
Well, I'm especially brilliant in my manipulation techniques.
I'm incapable of feeling shame.
And none of you have any desire to change, even though all these things lead to your demise?
No.
It's a good run while it lasts.
Boy, I don't necessarily love my flaws. I'm just complacent about them, and I don't have the energy or desire to change them.
I'm only here to support Claudius. I've made my peace with how he accidentally kills me by not telling me the wine I'm about to drink is poisoned.
Well, you, Polonia, why are you leading this meeting? I mean, you're a bit of a bumbling fool, but you're not a scoundrel.
Well, maybe not in the traditional sense, but I am very cruel to toy with my daughter's emotions the way that I do.
And you have no desire to change?
No. My allegiance is to my king. That is my sole purpose in life. Now, why don't you tell me a little bit more about what you hope to get out of this meeting?
Well, as I said, I was under the impression that this would be a place for those wishing to change. I mean, we all agree that we are pushing our children away by our bad behavior.
No, it's time that our husbands maintain the resolution that they come to at the end of the play. They do it so nicely, joining hands over the caskets of our dead children, but then as soon as the play is over, they're back to their old ways again.
We want them to change. Our children tried to help us reconcile, and we argued, and we fought, and nothing was accomplished. And we want that reconciliation for the sake of our children.
This is fascinating. I want reconciliation, too.
Oh, I thought you were here because you don't want to change.
I'm not so sure anymore. Oh. Ophelia confronted me about my treatment of her, and I felt very unhappy afterwards. I started to doubt the point of my own existence. I mean, you know, more than I normally do.
Gross.
I beg your pardon.
To be or not to be? Should I do it now? Should I wait until later? What is the point of life? Get thee to a nunnery! No, don't! I love you! Will you make up your pathetic mind already?
You think I care what you think? You onion-eyed miscreant?
Onion-eyed? You better watch who you mess with, Hamlet. I could send you into an existential crisis with one well-placed seed of doubt.
I'd like to see you try.
Oh, would you?
People! Yeah. Let us maintain the level of respect that we've always had for each other.
Respect? I don't respect anyone.
Well, I can see that we do not belong here.
Yes, perhaps you were looking for the Tragedians Anonymous group. They're the I can't believe what happens. I must have closure tight. They're down the hall.
Yeah. We're taking the chairs.
I'm coming with you.
You're leaving us.
Yes. I will. I can no longer fail to act. I wish to lead a better life.
Oh. Let him go. I'm never quite comfortable in his presence anyway. I'm always afraid he's about to poison my wine. Yes.
Well, that was interesting. How about we adjourn for today and then we reconvene at our next regularly scheduled meeting?
Sounds good to me. I need to go push somebody off a castle wall or something just to get rid of all the good feelings that are expressed here.
What's this?
Oh! It's addressed to Goneril.
Whoa!
It's a map.
Mine is too. Seekest thou riches, power, and grace? Follow this map and seek the place where the moon is wont to shine to claim the riches that are thine. Is that what everyone says?
Well, I didn't get one.
I don't like it. It smacks of treachery. And I know treachery. But I must admit I'm intrigued by the riches, power, and grace.
I think it's a pyramid scheme sales pitch.
It might be a party. I think we should go.
Oh, as long as you don't poison my punch.
Are the rest of you coming?
I could use some mystery and excitement.
I don't know. Hamlet could be behind this.
I'm going. I want to see what's in it for me. Richard?
Oh, absolutely. I'm always seeking more power, and I could use some new jewels for my crown.
Perhaps a treasure-seeking field trip is exactly what this group needs to reaffirm their resolve to be scoundrels. Sorry I wasn't invited. I want a full report at the next meeting.
Everybody understand their part. It should not be that difficult once everyone gets here. You know what to do, right?
Oh, I've missed plotting and scheming with you, my dove. We really should do more of this.
I'm having second thoughts. I'm feeling the madness coming on again. What if I start raving about like a lunatic again?
I think we need to rethink this. I'm getting cold feet.
Oh, will these hands never be clean? You see, I'm starting to see the blood on my hands again. Oh, this is all wrong.
Will you three relax? There's nothing more exciting than a scheme like this.
Look, but what about all the other innocent characters, though? Like the messengers and like the servants and the other like ladies-in-waiting. Look, they have nothing to do with us, and they face like certain like annihilation at our hands. This is wrong. This is all wrong.
I knew these two would chicken out. They're too full of the milk of human kindness, and she's always been weak. Letting a little murder make her go insane. I thought I could trust her. She's proven herself worthless.
All the perfumes in Arabia will ne'er sweeten this little hand.
Oh, I'm out.
Oh, no. You know way too much to back out now.
No, I should never have agreed to this in the first place. There is something devilish about you, Anne.
Well, it comes from over 400 years of being murdered by Richard over and over and over again.
I got them! I broke a lot of rules, but I got them! I enlisted the help of some humans I know on the outside. It seems Mr. William Shakespeare has a few enemies who are all too willing to have a hand in the complete eradication of his work.
Oh, this is so sick and wrong! I want my mommy!
They're coming. Everybody get in position. You know what to do. Come on.
Silver and diamonds and emeralds and rubies. Where are
they? I don't know. Where is it?
Where is it? Yeah. Where's the
treasure? I thought it would be here.
It looks like it should be here.
I feel as though we're being watched.
I thought there would be other people here.
Oh, where's the punch?
Where's the punch? Oh!
I could not believe you all fell for that riches, power, and grace thing. Dear God, you're a pretty gullible bunch. Oh.
This is a pyramid scheme. I demand to know why you have trapped us in this way. I'm simply here for the joy of a murderous plot. But Anne has a personal vendetta against Richard, and
Amelia's here to get back at Iago.
Well, what has this got to do with us? Let me and my sister go!
Cordelia was here to get revenge on you two, but it seems she's chickened out, as has Desdemona.
And I was to get revenge on Gertrude as well, but she's not here.
Well,
but all right.
None of this has anything to do with Reagan and I. Let us out.
Oh, but you do play a part in all this, don't you, Goneril? You and your sister are part of the culture of evil that Shakespeare's written into his plays. You cause such harm and wreak such havoc that the innocent don't stand a chance against you. But we say, no more.
Amelia, the manuscripts, please.
What?
I hold in my hand the original first folio of all of Shakespeare's manuscripts. They were gathered together by his friends after his death before they were even typed up for the printers.
Where did you get those?
Oh, so you have the originals. So what? You can't hurt us.
Oh, shall we see?
I don't buy it, Macbeth. Well, let's just test it out, shall we? Here, Queen Lear. I think I'll write in that Reagan has a terrible stomach cramp.
Oh my God, stop! We're gonna write you all out of existence!
We're not evil, but you're insane!
Yes, Jill.
You can see, we have been told the most important things in literature.
We have been told that when we rewrite the play from within, the play is forever changed. And we can do exactly that, write you out of existence.
Oh. You snuff out the greatest body of literature the world has ever known?
Exactly! Yes!
May I do the honors?
Please.
I have a gift for writing.
Mr. Escovine Macbeth! Stop!
All right, I want those manuscripts.
Give them to me.
And deaths of these two young people, humankind has learned to think about the intolerances that lead to war. And where would we be without the lessons of King Lear and the self-destruction that comes from vanity? Same with Hamlet, Macbeth, Richard III, Othello. All these plays show us the destruction that can come of one or two fatal flaws and the healing that comes of a virtue. Without these plays, people would not have the same opportunity to learn what it means if they fail to look within themselves and change what must be changed. So, while you tragic characters rage on about your outrageous fortune, know this. Know that you provide human beings with important, profound ideas and lessons
to live their lives by. There is no greater existence than that.
So, like, I guess I'll, like, see you at next week's meeting.
I'll be there.
I shouldn't have.
What?
I shouldn't have watched you struggle in the water. I should have saved you.
Come, Doctor. I can't believe I almost lost you again.
Wait. I still have no identity. Where's everyone going? What is Hamlet's fatal flaw?
There are many excellent books written on this subject. I suggest you start there.
I guess I better get a library card.
I will build a monument to Romeo to match that which Montague is building to my daughter.
Richard, Iago, Mistress Queen Macbeth, Lady Macbeth, are you ready to return to your plays and behave as usual?
Oh, as I said before, I have no wish to change. I only want to be left alone to commit murder and become king.
Wish or no wish, you are a powerful example of what happens when people fall under the power of corruption and evil. And you, Iago, I know you know what a perfect illustration of diabolical evil you are.
Oh, and proud of it.
You serve an important purpose in literature, too.
Well, I don't have time for your literary analysis, Professor. I'm busy. I've got to go and plot Othello's demise again.
Come, my dear, shall we continue as we were?
Yes, my queen.
Oh, wait for me. You can't teach mankind any lessons without me.
Our revels now are over. These, our actors, are melted into air, into thin air. We are such stuff as dreams are made on, and our little life is rounded with a sleeve.